Hello students, in the last class we have discussed about fiscal policy and taxation, under which we have learned direct tax and indirect tax. So today in this video we will learn about merits of direct tax and demerits of direct tax. So what are direct tax? So the direct tax are those tax the burden of which is borne by the same person to whom it is levied, like income tax. Clear? Now let us see one by one the merits of direct tax. The first merit is economical. So direct taxes are economical, as the cost of collecting this tax is low as they are collected at source. Clear? Number two, certainty. Now government knows the definite amount of tax to be paid and received. That is the reason they have certainty. Next one, reducing inequalities. So direct taxes helps in reducing inequalities, as rich pays more tax and poor people pays less tax. Clear? And the last one, fifth one, elasticity. Like government revenue will increase when the rate of tax will increase. When rates of tax will increase, government will receive more revenue. As why the rate of taxes increase? When income of the consumer or income of the household increases, automatically the rate of tax will increase. That is the reason when income government revenue increases with increase in rate of tax, and government revenue decreases with decrease in the rate of tax. So these were the merits of direct tax. Now we'll see the demerits of direct tax. The first one is unpopular. So taxpayers feel burden. The taxpayers who pay direct tax, they feel burden directly, as the burden of this tax cannot be shifted. Like indirect tax, the burden of tax can be shifted, but direct tax, the burden of this tax cannot be shifted to one person to another. Next one is tax evasion. Tax evasion means some of the times it happens that individuals, they try to avoid tax. They try to avoid tax by showing less income. If they show less income, they have to pay less tax. So that situation is called tax evasion, and it is a illegal or criminal offense. Number three, inconvenient. So direct tax, if the individuals who are paying direct tax, they need to maintain many accounts and they have to follow many formalities. So direct taxes are inconvenient. Next one, number four, direct tax has adverse effect on will to work and save, as high rate of tax will discourage the individuals, as the last part of the income goes to the hands of government. So these were the merits and demerits of direct tax. Now we'll see merits and demerits of indirect tax. Now indirect tax are those tax whose burden can be shifted from one person to another. Clear? Now let us see the merits of indirect tax. The first merit is convenient. So these taxes are paid in small amount and are included in the price of commodity. That is the reason they are convenient. Next one, less tax evasion. So indirect taxes are not evaded easily. Why? Because these taxes are included in the price of the commodity. Clear? Next one, wider coverage. So indirect taxes has wider coverage because it is imposed on large variety of goods, so that most of the individuals can contribute something in revenue of the government. Clear? Next one, equity. Equity means direct taxes has equity, in the sense like taxes are more on luxury goods and taxes are less on essential commodities or goods. Next one, social welfare. Now indirect taxes helps in social welfare, as consumptions of goods which are harmful, such as wines and cigarettes. So the taxes, indirect taxes on cigarettes and wines is more. Why? So that the consumption of these goods can be minimized. Clear? So these were the merits of indirect tax. Now let us see the demerits of indirect tax. The first one is discourage saving. Now indirect taxes are included in the price of goods, so people have to spend more on commodities, hence they can't save. Number two, inflationary. Now imposition of this tax can increase the price of commodities. That is the reason they are called inflationary. Number three, uneconomical. Now, administrative cost of collecting these tax are generally high. That is the reason they are uneconomical. And the last one, uncertainty. Now, revenue from this tax cannot be estimated correctly as their burden is shifted to many persons. So, estimation is not possible. So, that is the reason they are uncertain. Clear? So, these were the merits and demerits of direct tax and indirect tax. So, that's all for today. Thank you, students.